let's see the same thing from schedule 3. In schedule 3, transition T1, several operation of transition T1 execute, then several operation of transition T2 execute, then some operation of transition T1 execute, then remaining operation of T2 execute. We are calling this transition schedule 1 and schedule 3 are equivalent. See how these are equivalent. Again, just consider value of A is 100 and value of B is 200. Just consider. Read A, value of A is 100, and subtract 50 rupees from A, it will be write A, and transition T2 will read this value 50 and temp, and take another variable temp, 10% of A, 10% of 50 is 5, means the value of temp is 5, and deduct this that temp value from A. 50 minus 5 is 45, and write A. The 45 has been written into disk. Transition T1 read B is 200, initial value is 200, add 50 rupees, 250, and write into B and commit. Transition T1 has been completed. Read B, transition T2 read B is 250, plus B plus temp, temp is 5, 250 plus 5 is 255. And write B, final value B of 250 is written, and commit. Means transition T1 and transition T2 is successfully completed. And after, before this transition has started, the initial value is 100 and 200 is just a sum of 300. And after completing this two transition or this schedule 3, A is 45 and 2 is 255. Again, it's the summation of this A plus B is 300. Means it's consistent. Means our database is consistent. So what in transition T1 is happening, before transition start is 300, after transition is 300, and transition 3 is also before transition started is 300, and all completing after completing these two transitions T1 and T2 is 300. So we can call transition schedule 1 and schedule 3 is equivalent. In the same way, schedule 2, there is the same thing, 300 before start 300, after completing this schedule is 300. So schedule 1, schedule 2 and schedule 3, we can call it equivalent. Check for the schedule 4. Check for schedule 4. Initial value of A is, again just consider, is 100 and B is 200. One thing here, notice, I'm just separating transition T1 and transition T2 here. Why I'm separating, you will see. Read A, it read value of A from the disk, which is 100, and deduct 50 rupees . This 50 we will not write here, because the write operation is not executed yet. Write operation will execute later. So this 50 will written into temporary A of transition T1. In transition T2, it will read A. It will the transition T2 read the value of A from the disk, not from the temporary value of transition T1. So the value of A, it will read 100. Because the value of A in the disk is 100. Temp, it will a variable temp. Temp equals to A of 10% of A. A is 100 and 10% of this is 10. And write A. Deduct A minus temp. Temp value is 10 and A value is 100, so it will 90. Then write A. When the write operation will execute, then only we will write this value into disk. So the A value here we will write is 90, because the write operation of transition T2 has been complete, is executed. Read B, transition T2, read B, the B from the disk. The value of B in the disk is 200. So here 200. Then the next operation is write A. The value of A, it will write 50 into disk. So it will write, overwrite this value 90 as 50, and read B, the value from the disk. So the value of B is 200. It's 200, and 850 rupees in this variable is 200 plus 50 is 250. Then write B. So the value, the local variable, local values of B, we will write into disk is 250. And commit, the transaction T1 has been completed. Commit means the transaction has been successfully completed all operations. And transaction T2 will B plus temp, it read 200 from the disk, and it will add the temporary value. The temp value is 10, so 200 plus 10 is 210, and it will write B. So write B means what is the current value, current value of B into disk. It will overwrite this value and 210 it will write. So here you can see, before start this schedule, the value of A and B, means A plus B, is 100 plus 200, which is 300. And after completing this schedule, value of A and B, check, value of A written is, final value of A is 50, just where am I writing, plus it is 50, final value is 210, which is 210 plus 50 is 260, which is not equivalent to 300. So in transaction T2, we are losing our database consistency. Initial value of A and A plus B is 300, but after completing this schedule 4, our value A plus B is 260. It means we are our data is inconsistent. The following concurrent schedule does not preserve the sum A plus B.